in. We just thank the Lord tonight because God is good. And all the time, God is good. Amen. He is good all the time. Now, tonight, I just got a quick word for you. Just come on in. Amen. State where you're from. Glory to God. Amen. We are protected. We have to understand that we are covered under the blood of Jesus Christ and that God has his hands upon us in this season of our life. Amen. Come on, where you're from? As you come in, let me just state where you're from. Glory to God. We're going to give time for our audience to generate. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, just state where you're from. Glory to God. Blessings to you. Blessings to you. Blessings to you. Just a quick word, real quick. I believe that God just dropped something in my spirit. I wanted to just encourage you all on briefly in Psalms 91. Just want to talk about that a little bit because we have to understand the power behind this text. Amen. And even though the corona pandemic is going on, we got to understand that God is covering us in this very hour. Amen. And we don't have to be afraid of what the enemy is doing because God is working on the behalf of the body of Christ. Amen. And I'm excited about that because we can stand strong in the face of adversity knowing that God is for us. And if God is for you, who can be against you? Amen. But God is truly bringing us into an age of innovation where he's bringing transformation to the body of Christ. Amen. I believe that the church is being re-imaged where God has given us a new face, a new blueprint, a new vision. Amen. A new stance, a new faith walk with God. Amen. He's teaching us how to trust him like we have never seen before. Amen. So Psalms 91 is a powerful text, amen, where God is speaking, amen, to the hearts of his people. And he's telling us, amen, that we do not have to be afraid of anything that's going on. Amen. Any report that we get, amen, we can always stand on the word of God and believe that if God is for us, who can be against us? Glory to God. So I'm just going to give you some scriptures today, some things that God put in my spirit. God bless you all for tuning in tonight. Come on, just share this broadcast. Amen. Just come in quickly. I just want to bless you in the name of the Lord. Psalms 91. I'm going to talk about that. Praise God. Amen. As the Lord gave it to me. Amen. In Psalms chapter 91. Glory to God. Amen. Amen. In Psalms 91. Let's read. And when it says in Psalms 91 verse 1. Let's read what it says. And he who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. We have to understand that as we abide under the shadow of the Almighty, that God is covering us. And we don't have to be scared about what's going on around us because when God is protecting you, when he's covering you, nothing can infiltrate its way into that protection over your life. And as long as you are standing in right standing with God and the blood is on your life, when you put the blood of Jesus on your doorpost, when you cover yourself, you can be confident that nothing will happen to you. Amen. So no matter what's going on right now, I want to just tell you, beloved, that you can stand strong, believing and knowing that God is working things out on your behalf. Now watch this. In Psalms chapter 91, verse 2, let's read what it says. Hallelujah. Watch this here. And it says, and I will say unto the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in him will I trust. And you have to understand that you have to put your trust in God in this very hour. I understand, amen, what the government is saying. I understand what the news outlets are saying. But we have to put our trust in God, because God is the one that we need to keep our attention on in this hour, because God has a plan in all of this crisis. And you have to understand that as long as God is working behind the scenes, we don't have anything to be worried about, because he's not going to allow you to slip. He's not going to allow you, amen, to be taken out by a plague that he has power over. And as long as you abide in him and he abides in you, you can stand strong knowing that God will work things out on your behalf. Amen, somebody. So you have to believe in the God that you serve. Yes, I understand that there's things going on around us. Yes, I understand that everything is being shaken. Yes, I understand that there is a revival and a reset that's coming to the church. Yes, I understand that plagues and pandemics are rampant all around the globe. But you can stand tall and believe that God is still God, and he's still on the throne. Come on, somebody. And he has a plan for your life. Now watch this in Psalms chapter 91, verse 3. Amen. Let's just look at it real quick and let's see what it says in Psalms 91 and 3. And it says, surely he shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. And you have to understand, glory to God, that God is delivering you, amen, from all of these things. He's delivering you from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. Amen. There's a lot of things going on, but God will deliver you just because he loves you. And because God loves you and because he has a plan for your life, you can be confident that none of these things will come against you. Glory to God. And not only is he going to protect your life, he's going to cover the lives of your family members. So what we need to be doing as the body of Christ is standing on the wall as watchmen, praying, amen, against this thing that's trying to take us out. And as long as the church of the Lord Jesus Christ is here on this earth, we are the check and balance to any system. We are the check and balance to any demonic infiltration. This is the church's job to stand on the wall and rebuke what's trying to come against us. Glory to God. So I'm going to talk to the church today and tell you to arise in power, arise in your authority, and arise, amen, in the power of Christ Jesus. We need to begin to take authority over this thing, because it has no right to try to infiltrate its way as long as the body and the church is in charge. We still got dominion, beloved. God still gave us dominion on the earth. He still gave us rule. Yes, this Satan is the god of this world, but as long as the kingdom of God is in this world, glory to God, we can usurp his authority, because he's already been whipped by the Lord Jesus Christ. And because he has gave us victory, we can walk with this power and we can take this thing out in Jesus' name. Are y'all hearing me tonight? Glory to God. Now watch this. In Psalms chapter 91, verse 4 through 8, let's read this together. Okay? And it says, and he shall cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you shall take refuge. His truth shall be your shield and buckler. And you shall not be afraid of the terror by night. Again, verse 5 says, you shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor of the pestilence or the arrows that flies by day, nor of the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor of the destruction that lays at noonday. Are y'all hearing me tonight? So you have to understand, because God is still on the throne, we don't have to be concerned about the plagues and the pestilence, because God is working this thing out. He's covering us. He has a divine plan, and we are in the midst of calamity and crisis. And you have to be confident in this, that know that all of the prophets, amen, all of the ministry gifts, the ascension gifts, the sons and daughters of God, yes, the earth is groaning, yes, it's waiting for the manifestations of the sons of God, but you have to understand, as the sons of God, you have to believe in the God that you serve, and you have to understand that no matter what goes on in this earth, God is in control, because the church is in the building. Come on, somebody. Amen. We have dominion. He gave us charge, amen, and power
to me. He said, I'll give you power to tread upon serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. Glory to God. All the power. And if you have a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ, amen, he has gave you power to rebuke every demonic storm that we face. So I'm going to talk to you tonight and tell you, beloved, be encouraged and take your authority. This is the hour for the church to rise with power and strength, knowing that God is up to something great. Amen. And we got to keep our mind on him so that we can see the plan behind the plan. Now watch this. In Psalms chapter 91, verse 8 through 11. Let's read Psalms 91, verse 8 through 11. Amen. And I'm done. I just want to encourage you all tonight. Glory to God. Amen. And just let you know that all things are working for our good. Psalms chapter 91, verse 8 through 11. Let's see what it says. Because you have made the Lord your refuge, even the Most High your dwelling place. Number 10 says, no evil shall befall you. No evil shall befall you. Watch this. And no plague shall come near your dwelling. For he has given his angels charge over you. I want you to catch that. To keep you in all of your ways. He has given his angels charge over you. To keep you in all of your ways. No matter what's going on with your money, no matter what's going on with your job, no matter what's going on with your business, no matter what's going on in your family, no matter what's going on in this government, no matter what's going on around the nations of the earth, he has given his angels charge over you. Amen. The angels of the Lord are working on your behalf, beloved. So I want to encourage you to stand strong. Keep your stance. Stay on the wall. Amen. Speak this word with power and authority. And do what God is telling you to do. This new blueprint that he's giving you, this new download, this change that's coming about is for your good. Take everything that's going on for your good. Because God has a plan behind all of this. Father, I thank you tonight for blessing your people, Father. Lord God, I just wanted to speak an encouraging word to my Father God, to this let your people know, God, that as we stay in the secret place of the Most High, Lord God, everything is being protected, Father. Lord, you will not let our foot slip, oh God. In the name of Jesus, I give you glory, honor, and praise for blessing your people tonight. In Jesus' holy and righteous name, amen. God bless you all. Be encouraged. This too shall pass.